Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to track content that's hosted on AWS or Vercel or wherever hosting that you may have, and how to take that and track it through xAPI using a tool called XCL. Now, I've talked about XCL in the past. I've also talked about hosting your courses through AWS and through Vercel in previous videos as well, but I'm going to bring it all together because the goal of today's video is to really show you that you can track content no matter where it is. You can host the content somewhere, and then you can track it through using something like XCL. Now, XCL starts at $49 a month. They do have different levels, including an enterprise level as well. And you can actually try out XCL at the different levels using the Learning Dojo code. So if you go to XCL and you go ahead and just do the free account and you put in Learning Dojo, one word, capital L, capital D, it will give you a free 30-day trial of whatever level you want. And you can't get that without the code. So go ahead and check that out. I'll leave a link in the description below. Now, I have talked also about how to set up AWS. I'm not going to cover all the different settings that you have to do to begin with. I'm going to assume that you already have an S3 bucket here. If you want to check out how to set it up, you can check out one of my previous videos as well. And then we'll talk about Vercel. And I actually liked the simplification of Vercel, so I want to show both of those options. But in order to do this, we do need to publish it out from Storyline in a certain way. So I'm going to go into Storyline and show you how to do that to begin with. Now I have all of my xAPI custom statements here. Storyline does default statements to begin with as well. So if I come into here, I'm going to publish this out to LMS or LRS, and I'm going to publish this to my desktop for now. And the only thing I have to do is make sure that I publish to an xAPI package. That's it. We're not linking to another learning record store or anything like that. We're just publishing it to xAPI. Even though this course is going to be hosted on AWS or it's going to be hosted on Vercel, we are still making sure that it's an xAPI package to be able to track all of that content. I'm going to go ahead and click on publish here. Now, depending on the length of your course, the size of your course, it may take a little bit, but what it's doing is it's publishing to my desktop here. Oh, and there it is right here. So while that's uploading, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my AWS account. Now, inside of my AWS account, I'm going to go into my S3 bucket. Now, in my S3 bucket, I have three different buckets. On each of those buckets that you work with, you have to go into the permissions and then you have to adjust a couple of different things. That's where I'm saying check out that video that talks about all those different permissions. But you only need to do that once. Then every time I come in here to that bucket, I can upload whatever course I want. So you can see here, I've uploaded a bunch of courses and all I need to do is drag in this new course, this new folder once it's done, and I need to drag it in. Now, rule of thumb when you're working with web development is to get rid of spaces in your naming. You can either have that just go one word after the other, or you can have an underscore or something like that. I already have a cooking 101, so I'm gonna go ahead and just change this to cooking 102. I just have to drag my xAPI folder up there and then just click on upload. Now it will upload the content and then I can point to the right file. As easy as that inside of AWS once you have those settings ready to go. Any new course that I upload basically just gets uploaded to that bucket, and then I can point to the right file to create the XCL document here. So we'll wait for this to upload, and I want to show you how to preview this inside of AWS first, because we have to get the right link in order for XCL to work as well. So this is now uploaded. Let's click on close, and I'm going to go into cooking 102, and let's just preview the story.html for now. So I'm going to copy that and open this up in a different URL here or different tab, and this will take me right to my course. So that's how you host it, and you can have point people right to the course, but right now it's not tracking anything. It's not even capturing who the person is. That is the benefit of XCL, is capturing who the person is and then capturing all the xAPI data and putting it inside of XCL. All right, so I'm going to close that out, and then I'm going to go back into my AWS site here. Now with AWS, I actually need to not point to the story.html, but I need to point to the index_lms.html. This is what then enables the, like it was running in an LMS, it enables the tracking. So I need to go into that file and copy this URL right here. Once I'm there, I can now go into XCL. And with XCL, you create different branded templates. Those templates can be for different organizations or different departments in your organization. And then each of them can have their own branded style. But essentially, you're creating a template first. And I have videos that you can check out on how to create templates in XCL. I have two templates right now. And the first template I'm going to go ahead and go into, this is essentially just using XCL as our own LRS. If you have a learning record store, you can put in your own learning record store here, but you don't need it. $49 a month, you get your own learning record store through XCL. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead, and this is where you'd like to upload your branding, decide which fields you're going to capture, things like that. All right, so that is in place. So now all I need to do is create my link. This is the link to the course. So you're creating different links, and then you're going to have to make sure that your learners get to those links. So you can share them on a SharePoint site, you can share them on just an email or something like that. Or when you create a link, there's a QR code that people can scan as well. So however you want to distribute the links, that part's up to you. So I'm going to go ahead and click on create new link here. And we're going to call this one cooking and then 102. Then I decide which branded template that I want to use, which in this case is the XCL one. You can change the title and the instruction text as well. You can change the button and then browser tab. All right, so now I'm gonna go ahead and go to the next link. Now this is where you could have XCL host your content. You could upload SCORM packages and so forth. But for now, we have it hosted on AWS. So we're just gonna stick with that. So I'm gonna come into the URL and just paste that link that I got from AWS. Then I'm gonna go ahead and select this dropdown box and let XCL know that it's an xAPI published package. And you can also do this with just a regular web link, but there's no tracking xAPI data other than like clicking. You could do this with video, which the video does track like completion and other things. So that is nice. But right now we're just going to go ahead and do xAPI publish content. So the next step is basically publish the link. Hooray, we get the confetti and now we can copy that link. Now I'm going to go in here and just share that out. So right now, if I enter in my name, so let's enter in my name here, Jeff. My last name, Bats, my email, and then you can click on Remember Me. If I come back to this, I don't have to fill out the form anymore. This is a recent update that allows you to just go back in and resume where you left off as well. But I'm gonna go ahead and click on Continue here, and then I go through the course. So if I have custom xAPI statements, if I have all of that, basically you can go in and it will track all of that. Everything that Storyline by default reports through xAPI, all of that is tracked here. So I just go through and I start interacting with the course. And as I interact with the course, it sends over those xAPI statements. No need for me to have an LMS at this point. I basically just create the link, share out the link, and boom. So all of my content could be hosted on AWS. I'm going to go back into XCL. Let's click on exit. And this is the analytics. This is my dashboard, which I can create different types of dashboards to see progress. And this is just a simple dashboard, but I can select other dashboards like Cooking 102. I don't have any completed yet. It's just launched. I can also click to view user comparison. This does allow me to see specifically who's completed what and if they've gotten past or so forth. That's a fairly new feature, which is pretty nice as well. But then I can go into the activity stream. Now the activity stream will allow me to see all of the verbs that have come in. So I have experience left, but I also have custom verbs like right here, liked, when I clicked on that like button. All of this is the raw data. What I can do is I can come in and I can filter. This allows me to just pull in certain time periods or certain types of people as well, or different verbs or actions. You can filter out to what you want. And then the nice thing about that filter is when you download the CSV file here, you can then take that CSV, upload it to like Power BI, or you can upload it to other tools like Tableau, things like that, that will then allow you to create your own custom dashboards. That's as simple as it is to be able to get content, publish it out to AWS, and then create a link and then track that content. So the next thing I just want to make sure that you are aware is Vercel. Now Vercel is pretty cheap as well. And in Vercel, it basically ties to GitHub. So what you would do is you would upload your content to GitHub, and once it's inside of GitHub, when you sign up, you connect your GitHub, and once it's inside of GitHub, you create a link at that point. So I'm going to go into GitHub, and I'm going to create a new repository here. So the repository name is going to be Cooking102. Once you sign up for GitHub, you can do that. You can change the visibility if you're on a paid account or if you're not on a paid account, so you can change it to private if you want. And I'm going to go ahead and click on Create Repository here. Now, if you create a repository, you can then upload files into here. There's a couple different ways to upload files. So you can do quick setup, setup in desktop, or you can actually upload an existing file right here. I think I can just drag and drop, and let me not upload the folder. What I want to do is upload everything like that. So I just dragged in all of the files, and then I have the upload there. Now, whenever you upload files, you need to give it a title, or at least a name down at the bottom here. It has a lot of files inside of this course, so you can see the progress. Let's go ahead and wait for that to finish. I like to use Vercel because I use GitHub a lot, and all of my projects are already on GitHub. And so once your project is on GitHub, it basically just publishes out. So that's one of the benefits to it. Now, GitHub essentially is a way for you to keep track of different versions. And so if you create and publish a new version, you can version control, revert back to a version, and so forth. All right, so all of these are ready. So let's just say initial load and then click on commit changes. Now it's going to go ahead and process all of that. And then once that's done, I can then go and search for cooking 102 inside of Vercel. Okay, so all of that is done. Now this GitHub is not initially previewable inside of here. So we need to actually go into Vercel and then click on add new. We're going to do add new project. And then we're going to go ahead and search, and it'll pull in all my GitHub stuff. And look, cooking 102 is right there. So I'm going to go ahead and click on import. You can adjust some of the settings if you wanted to, like what project it's going to go in, and then just click on deploy. So this will take a couple of seconds to deploy. Okay, so it is deployed now, but we need to, just like with AWS, we need to get to that one file, that index LMS file. So let's go into our dashboard. Now this is a challenge because we don't have the files just viewable right here. What I can do though, is I can copy this right here. So if I just go ahead and click on this little arrow, is I then add to that cooking or index. Let me go into here. I don't need to do cooking 101 because we're already in that folder, but we just need to do index lms.html. There we go. So we're just pointing to the right file. Now this isn't going to load right here because we're not in an LMS. If I was to change this to story.html, it would load because it's loading outside of that. But what I want to do is point to this index LMS. All right, so there's a couple extra steps with Vercel. So you can add on the index, and then you can use that link for the xAPI publish package as well. And then you would just do the same thing. You would create the link inside of XCL and then send out the link from there. So hopefully this has been helpful for you. Again, you can sign up for a free trial by using the Learning Dojo code. If you like AWS, great, stick with AWS. If you like Vercel, great, use Vercel as well. I just wanted to show at least two different options to be able to host your content somewhere and be able to track it through XCL and how easy that is. If you like this channel, go ahead and click on the like button and subscribe to my channel, as well as hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows me to reach more learning developers like yourself to really show you how to extend and customize content and go beyond the traditional just PowerPoint type of experience here. That really is the goal of my channel. You can also check out more by going over to my website at learningdojo.ninja. You can check out apps that I've created. You can also check out previous courses. So if you wanted to dive all the way into xAPI, you can do xAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Storyline, JavaScript for Storyline, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and more. You can also check out previous blog posts where I cover all different learning types of development topics here. That's all I have for today. So thanks everyone. I'll see you next time.